As well, you guys, we'll have a quick chat about what we're doing. What we're going to try and do this morning, anyway, we're just going to pretty much get moving. We're not going to do any specific kind of warm-up because it's so cold that I just want to get warm. So we'll get you as warm as quick as we can, and then we'll get moving to the workout. Okay, so again, something key is left out here. There's a 16-minute time cap on this, guys. Okay, so you have 16 minutes trying to get it done, so it will be a bit of a push to actually get it done on the time. So you have a run at the start and at the end. If we're not running, we're doing some sort of cardio or some 2 minutes of cardio, right? So essentially, if you take that out, there's 4 minutes gone in the workout, so you've 12 minutes left to pretty much complete the rest of the work, all right? So you're going to do 4 dumbbell rows. You can do your 20 pull-ups if you have a pull-up bar as well. You're then going to move on to 60 sit-ups. You've then 80 dumbbell or kettlebell snatch. So if you're on the dumbbell, guys, we're going to go from the floor. If we're on a kettlebell, you can go from the hang. And then we're going to go 60 sit-ups again, 40 rows or 20 pull-ups again, and then your 2 minutes of cardio to finish off. So it's a kind of a pyramid scheme chipper. You go all the way up and then come all the way back down the other side. Okay. Pretty straightforward, guys. Any questions on it?
If I'm doing ring rows, how many do I do?
20.
20, perfect.
Do the 20 instead of the 4. Just in case anyone's wondering, you have to complete, so you have to do the 40 rows before you can move on to the sit-ups and so on. You can't just split it up anyway. Yeah, okay. What I'm going to ask you guys, just to start off for a minute, I'm just going to ask you to do some sort of cardio, whether you want to do jumping jacks, toe taps, high knees, butt kicks, whatever you want to do. I just want you to move.
Jump on the bike.
Go in 3, 2, 1. Off we go, guys. Brilliant, guys. You just have 30 seconds. Thank you.
Bye.
Lovely, guys. You can relax out of that. Let's get some range of motion into the legs. I just want you to give me 5 air squats. Once you've that going, guys, I want you to flow straight into 10 hamstring bounds. So try and get a bit of length into your hamstrings. Reaching for that toe, just trying to get as much length into the hamstring as possible. Once you've that done, guys, if you just grab your weight that you're going to use for the workout, what I'm going to ask you to do, guys, is I'm going to ask you to give me 5 presses overhead. On your 5th press, guys, I want you to keep it up there, and I want you to give me 5 shrugs up to the ceiling. I just want you to give me 5 inchworms, and I just want you to inchworm all the way out, and I want you, as far as possible, reach out as far as you can. Once you've done that, walk it all the way back in. So, basically an inchworm plank, but I want you to reach out as far as you possibly can. When you think you've gone as far as you can, go a little bit further. Really, guys, once you've that done, we're going to get our weight again, and we're just going to go for 5 deadlifts on each arm. So dumbbell or kettlebell, just deadlift it all the way to the floor, making sure my hips are coming down with the dumbbell. 5 on each arm. Once you've that done, guys, I want you to transition straight into give me 5 dumbbell rows or kettlebell rows on each arm. So I want you to hinge all the way over. Think about getting your chest parallel with the floor. Shoulder blades are pinned together at the back, guys. So once you have your dumbbell, your deadlifts done, just into 5 rows. Last thing I'm asking for, guys, is 5 dumbbell snatch on each arm. But what I want you to think about, guys, is I'm coming down to get a dumbbell, big jump, press overhead. As I'm coming back to the floor, I have to make sure I'm bringing my hips back down once that dumbbell gets past my knee. So I'm not just hinging over like that and pulling with my back. My hips are down, my back is flat, jump and overhead. I want you to give me 5 on each arm. Remember, guys, really important, guys, flat back and your hips are coming to the floor each time. Brilliant, guys. We're just going to take a second or so before we crack into it. Just a quick reminder of the workout. Again, guys, it starts off with your 400 meter run or your 2 minutes of cardio. You're doing your 40 dumbbell rows, your 60 sit-ups, your 80 snatches, and then back through it again. So 60 sit-ups again, 40 rows, and a 400 meter run. Any questions, guys? Does anyone else need it? Does anybody need anything changed or anything? Rachel, are you writing down the whole workout for yourself?
Yeah, are you going to leave it up?
I'm not. I'm going to have a clock up instead of...
Yeah, I don't want to forget it. That's okay. Give me 2 seconds.
That's all right. Take your time.
But what about the cardio, like jumping jacks or something? So
you can do jumping jacks. You could do burpees for 2 minutes if you'd like. Oh, geez. You can do high knees. You can do butt kicks. You can do toe taps.
Thank you.
Even if you want, Sarah, you can pick it up. So you can do like 30 seconds of jumping jacks, 30 seconds of high knees, 30 seconds of butt kicks, and then 30 seconds.
Yeah, because we get to the boring, all right.
Okay, that's fine as well.
Berger, will you time that for us? Will you time the 2 minutes or do we need a timer?
I'll have the clock up for you.
Cool, okay, thanks.
Everyone will have a different 2 minutes at the end.
Yeah.
At the start, I'll give you a shout when the first 2 minutes is up, but at the end, everyone will have a different 2 minutes. Brilliant, guys. Just give me a thumbs up sign. Are you ready to go? So we're going to go in 3, 2, 1. Off we go, guys. 2 minutes of cardio of some sorts. We'll be right back. Lovely, guys. You're a minute in. Any more seconds? There's the 2 minute mark, guys. You're into your 40 dumbbell or kettlebell rows. So remember, guys, flat back, shoulders are pinned together. Time midline. Once you're done with your rows, guys, you're into 60 sit-ups. There's a 16 minute time cap on this, so you need to be halfway through the snatches at the 8 minute mark. Guys, keep moving out. You're just coming up to the 5 minute mark. Reps is a lot of reps here, guys. Really paying attention on lowering your hips down and a flat back. please. Guys, there's the 8 minute mark. That's the halfway point of the workout. Once your snatch is done, you're back to your sit-ups again. Lovely, guys. There's the 10-minute mark. You've 6 minutes left. And two of that 6 minutes, guys, has to go towards your 2 minutes cardio.
I'm going to go.
Lovely, guys. 4 minutes left. Lovely, guys. You're in the final 2 minutes now. If you're not on the cardio, you're just trying to get as much work done as you can for the last 2 minutes. If you're on the cardio, work, guys. Work it as fast as you can to get the workout done. Go, Mandana. Final minute, guys. If you're pushing to get it done, let's get it done as quick as we can. If not, guys, we're trying to get as much work done as we can. Seconds left, guys. Ten seconds. Three, two, one, time. Lovely stuff, guys. We just take a quick couple of seconds. Let you catch your breath. We're going to move straight into just a quick stretch, guys. Nothing too major. I already suspect that the sit-ups were grim, were they?
Yeah. 60 is a big number.
All I'm going to do, guys, is we're going to lie down, we're going to pull that knee all the way into our chest, and I'm just going to drop that knee across my body. I'm just going to hold this, guys, for just about 45 seconds. Just get the
scale on here. You get a tight back after that, which should hopefully pull on your back erectors.
Oh, yeah.
Nice, guys. About 15 more seconds and we'll swap sides. And relax out of that, guys. We'll swap the legs. So again, I'm pulling the knee into my chest first. And then I'm gonna get that knee to drop all the way across my body. About 15 more seconds, guys. And relax out of that, guys. Last thing I'm gonna do, guys, 30 seconds on each side. I'm just gonna stretch out the shoulders. We're gonna come into this nice little T shape. Slide back down more. Coming into this T shape. I'm then going to take my left leg, I'm going to bring it all the way over towards my right hand. I'm then going to use my left hand to press into my right shoulder. I'm getting the stretch on my right shoulder here. We'll hold it for just 30 seconds. And relax out of that, guys. Let's roll back over onto the opposite side. Get a stretch on the opposite shoulder for me. Okay, guys, we're just looking for 30 seconds here so you can afford to get a little bit deeper into the stretch. And slowly come out of that, guys. Lovely stuff for everybody.
Thanks, Ferg.
See you later. Have a good day, all right?
You see you later.
Thanks, Ferg. See you soon.
Guys. Thanks.